అది ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ టు ఈ జాయిన్ సాఫ్ట్ సెషన్ డైరెక్ట్ ఈ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ టు సాఫ్ట్ సెషన్ డైరెక్ట్ 2017 ఆర్కి క్లియర్డ్ అపెండిక్స్ 3 ఎగ్జామ్ ద ఇస్ ఏ ఎస్ఐ క్వాలిఫైడ్ ఎస్ఎస్ ఫామ్ అండ్ ఐఎస్ఏ అండ్ రీసెంట్లీ క్వాలిఫైడ్ ఎల్ఈసీఏ అవి బికమ్ ఏ జూనియర్ స్కిల్ ఆఫీసర్ ఏడబ్ల్యూ ఫ్రో సిఆర్ఎస్ తిరుపతి ప్రాబబ్లీ ఈస్ ద యంగెస్ట్ ఆఫీసర్ యంగెస్ట్ రూకీ ఆఫీసర్ ఇన్ ఇండియన్ రైల్వేస్ ఈస్ 30 ప్లస్ వెరీ ప్యాషనెట్ అబౌట్ టీచింగ్ వెరీ ప్యాషనెట్ అబౌట్ దిస్ కంప్యూటరైజేషన్ And he is an expert in this workshop of ours. I request Sri Udai Kiran, please commence your session. Over to you.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Please carry on.
Yes, sir. Good morning, everyone. Hope everyone is safe in COVID times. And I'm very happy that Team Sitara is conducting and disseminating the classes. Very good morning, and I thank Sitara team for providing me an opportunity to meet you all and teach something which I know. And I should say proudly that because of Sitara, I'm here. I used to attend every class in Sitara and I used to improve my knowledge.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Because of you, I'm here. I'm 100% confident. Yeah, and coming to today's class on EOFS, it is a very practical approach class. Nothing to learn new things from this, but the thing is we should know what to do, when to do and how to do. That is the only thing. I will be giving my presentation and it will be really user-friendly.
Sir, I
request you to mute it, sir. Mute everyone, sir. Sure, sir. Anytime. If they have any doubts, they can ask me on chat. I will be ready on the chat. I will be clearing all the doubts from chat.
Muting everyone?
Yes, sir, please. Yeah, today's class is e-office. Because of COVID, the importance of e-office has been improved. Okay, it's a very dry subject. Only thing is, when you open, how to open the e-office, what are the requirements of e-office, and what to do. And how we used to, we should handle the files and docs received in your office. This is the thing what I want to share with you. Before that, what I want to say is, what we handle in office. We used to handle files and we used to handle letters, office orders, representation, memorandums, joint procedure orders, circulars, etc. And what we used to do with that. See, they used to receive a paper copy, a paper, a letter or a representation. Okay, if we receive a letter in R&D section, what we do? We used to distribute to the concern section. From there, they will put up in the concern file on the folio side, and the section staff along the section officer will write a noting for orders and put up to the officer. Okay, and from there, the officer will give orders and a reply. A letter will again be prepared by the concern section and will be sent to the representer. In that way, that the issue will used to be closed. This is before e-office implementation. And even in accounts department, we will be receiving a lot of files from the executive saying that I need concurrence, I need vetting, and all the papers will be sent in their file. When the accounts deal the our notice and approvals in their file, the file will be sent back to the executive department. For that, what we used to do is, as and when we receive a file from the executive department, we will prepare a parallel file taking all copies of necessary documents, and then we will put up an accounts file in the folio side. From there, will write, start writing a note. The section staff will write a note and then they will put up SSO. And then to officers, as usual, at all levels, it will cross all levels. And whether it is approved or returned, we will get the orders of the officer. And a letter will be prepared. And that letter will be filed in the folio side of executive's file. And we will send back that file along with our letter to the executive. This used to be happening. And the fiscal file movement and the letter received fiscally when before e-office. Okay, and for introduction of e-office, what are the prerequisites? The prerequisites for implementation of e-office is RailNet. See, we have in many broadbands, but e-office can't be opened in any of the broadbands. For opening of e-office, we need RailNet at any cost. And second thing is, we need a digital signature, and in the first login, DSC, digital signature should be registered in our e-office ID. And we need one government email ID or NIC mail ID. And any browser with DSC service signer and Java 32 bit. If that system doesn't have this DSC service signer and Java 32 bit, the e-office will not work. That means that the person can't sign the paper on e-office. Means the user can't be signed. For that, what I will give the one PDF how to download the DSC signer and Java 32 bit, and also how to register the digital signature. These two things I will be giving. One PDF already I have attached and given to Sitara. He will circulate it to you. And in the back end, what will happen is, for every e-office, for zonal railway, one nodal officer will be there, and also for every unit, one admin will be there. Okay, what are the main duties of admin and nodal officer is, the nodal officer will see that it is the e-office is 100% implemented, and whether the users are created and roles are given to each and every user. Admin at unit level, what he does is, he will give a hierarchy, means from accounts clerk to SO, from SO to officer, officer to ADFM, means okay, officer to SO to ADFM, ADFM to senior DFM. This hierarchy, whether the roles are defined or not, and if not, if any input or output officers, like if any officer is coming inside or if any officer was transferred outside, that will be taken care in e-office by the admin at unit level. Means the roles and hierarchy are already created and maintained by the administration in all units. Okay, this will be in the back end. These are all nothing to us, and it is not required for using the e-office. Okay, because we are only users, we should know how to deal with the doc, what to do when a letter is received, and how to be filed, whether how to attach to folio side, and how the noting in the note should be written in the noting side, what is yellow note, green note, and how to put up to the next level. That is what we require. These prerequisites will be taken care by the JEIT or SEIT of each unit. Okay, if any problem persists, just call your JEIT or SEIT, and they will take care of all these things. Okay, next we are going to e-office. See, I will show you the presentation, and I will also try to give the live demo opening my e-office account, and I will show you whatever I say now, I will show it to you. Okay. See how to open e-office. To open e-office, just open any browser, and you can use this ser.eofficerailnet.gov.in for South Central. If for other railways, this SER can be replaced by ER, SR, or ECOR if it is East Coast Railway, and SWR for Southwestern Railway, and NR for North Railway, MR for Western Railway, etc. Or if you doesn't know this, directly you can go and write IR, IndianRailways.eOffice.railnet, where all railways login is available. Once the login screen is displayed, okay, you can log in with your Govin or NIC mail ID. My Govin mail ID is urekiran.mora@gov.in. There, the login ID should be used only as urekiran.mora@gov.in can be omitted as your login ID. Next, this is your log screen. As I already told you, you can see the login ID. There, I have given only urekiran.mora, and as usual, my mail ID password is the password for logging into e-office. Once you log in, this is the home screen of eOffice. Okay, you can check if the profile whether it is logged on your name or not. If any corrections, like any spelling mistake or any other mistake found in this, you can ask your JEIT to edit that. Here you can see the profile on the right hand top. Okay, to enter into the eOffice, you can click the file management system where highlighted with red color or e-file. Okay, by clicking on e-file or file management system, we can enter into the eOffice screen. Right, this is the main eOffice main screen. Okay, main screen of eOffice. Here we can see the receipts file, migrate file, dispatch, DSC, settings, notification, audit, etc. These are all the menus we are dealing now, which should be dealt by us. Receipts, highlighted receipts is we will receive all docs will be received and handled from this tab. And in file section, we will be receiving all files. And in DSC, as I told you, first time it should be activated and registered. Here, the DSC should be activated. These three are important for using. We are all users, only we need basics. That's why I'm only going through basics. Okay, next. Now I want to say what are receipts. Receipts are two types. Any letter, whether received physically or on eOffice, is any letter. It is called doc. When it is browsed and diarized, then it is called a receipt. Okay. Here there are two types. One thing, we receive something on paper that we can scan and diarize by ourselves. Second thing is, it was diarized by someone and sent to you as a receipt in your inbox. Only we have two types of receipts. One is we are creating one, and the other one is we are receiving it from other users. Okay, now I am showing how to create. Okay, in receipts, there is the first option called browse and erase. There, if you press browse and erase, automatically this screen will be appear with the blank space. There we have upload file. See, in the center of the page, there is a column called upload file. Tab called. There, if you press upload file, it will ask like to attach a file from your computer. Okay, you can select the D drive or E drive where you keep the scan copy, and you can upload it. And after uploading it, you should fill all the mandatory fields. This ID details, contact details, and category and subject, three main headings are there, right? All these three data are called metadata. These three metadata should be filled. All mandatory data should be filled, and then you should decide whether to generate and keep or generate and send to other person. Generate and keep it with you or generate and send to other person. These things you should decide. If you want to generate for putting it in your file, or then you just press generate. See here, to generate as attachment to any of your file, then you should press generate. If not, if you want to send to other person directly, then you just send that to send the receipt directly to other person or other user, then we can use generate and send. Okay, as I told you, this is the way we are browse and diarizing. All letters which are generated to browse and diarize can be seen. See, you have browse and diarize of 10 letters, 10 receipts at a time. Okay, where do you find that? To find that, in receipt section, there is a column called created. Okay, in that created folder, we will be seeing all the letters or receipts which are browse and diarized by us. Means by me, if I browse some 10 letters, that browse and diarize letter will be seen in this created folder. What I received from other users, that can be seen in inbox folder. See, I highlighted both here. One is inbox, where I received from the other users. And the created folder is where I browse and diarize and kept with me. Okay. Once I received a letter in inbox, when I click on the number, here is receipt number. If I click on this receipt number, it will open like this. The main body of the letter can be seen, and where, and it will give the movement details and receipt details. Who has, from whom I received it, and what is the movement, to whom it has been sent. Here there are options. Send means if I want to send to other person, that the send option can be used. If I want to send back the same, but if it is not pertaining to me, I will say send back and press this send back and send it to the send back to him directly from whom I have received. If not, if I want to put in some file, I will say that put in a file. Okay, this copy, the copy is not the copy of the letter. See, while browsing in Dyrus, in the metadata where I have this diary details, contact details, and category subject, these details will be copied, not the letter. Okay, these things are important in this one. Okay, and we are going to once if I press send here means if I want to send to the other user. If I want to send to the other, I will click send, and in to address, I will just type the name of the person to whom I should send. There, I can select that person and I can simply send this letter to him. Okay. Previously, what happened is, if I want to send a letter to Sikindrabad from here, to Sikindrabad from here, it used to take a lot of time. Means like I should take a print of the letter. There, then I should sign it, and then means like these days WhatsApp, everything we received, and we are using official WhatsApp also. But the thing is, we should not use that. We should fax. Either we should fax, or we should send it some person, or we should post it. It may take some 3 to 4 days. But as and when you select the name of the person here, it will go and sit in his inbox, in receipts inbox. It will go and sit. By this, we are saving a lot of time, and also we are saving lot of paper. And see, now we discussed about receipts. Now we have went to e-files. See, as you know, a physical file is of two parts: right side notings and left side correspondence or folio side. But in e-files, it will be reverse. Okay, the right side will be the folio side or correspondence side, and the left side will be noting side. The noting side will be always in green color, and the folio side will always be in white color. And you see, the right side is of folio and correspondence, and the left side will be of noting in e-office. Okay, here e-office again, e-files are again of two types: one which we can create new files, or the files which are received from other users. There are two types. One is we will be creating our files, and the second one is we are receiving from files for others. We should know how to deal both. That I will show it to you now. See, whatever files we are received from others, it will be shown in files tab inbox. Whatever we receive from others, if you want to create in that only, there is a column called in files tab only. There is a column called create new. From this, we can create new files. Okay, you can also create new files. The third method is, as and when you receive a receipt, okay, there is an option called put in a file. When you say put in a file, it will ask whether it is an existing file or new file. Existing file or new file. Okay, when you say new file, it will ask whether it is a SFS or non-SFS. SFS means single file system. Okay, SFS means like if you select SFS, you should give all the details like file number, everything. Normally in Dyrus, we are using non-SFS because we want to give a systematic and standard manner for all the files. So we are selecting non-SFS, non-single file system, and we are selecting and we are creating files. I will show it here. See, as and when you say create new and non-SFS, this is the screen which it will be shown. You should select the file number, the other data should be selected, and you should give the description of the file, and you should say continue working. By this, a file will be created with a noting side blank and a folio side blank. Don't confuse with it. It is already noting has been written because I want to reduce the slides. As and when you create a new file, blank noting will be there, and also blank folio side will be there. Okay, see, you have opened a file and you should file something on the folio side, right? Further, if you want to attach a receipt in the folio side, you should click on the TOC. TOC means table of contents. As and when you click on it, you will be getting an attach button, where as and when you press the attach button, already the you have kept something browse and digest, right? All these browse and digest documents will be shown here in the left side, and you can select one of the browse and digest documents and you say attach. Once you attach it, the attached document will be on the folio side of the file. Okay, this is the way to add a receipt to all on the folio side of the file. It's very easy. Again, I am going back. See, if you want to, as and when you open a new file, okay, you should attach a folio on the you should attach a receipt on the folio side. For that, you should press TOC. As and you press TOC, it means table of contents. Okay, you there will be attach button. As and when you attach button, whatever browse and digest documents are available with you, it will be shown there. And from there, the relevant document can be selected and it should be attached. As and you press attach, it will come on the folio side of the file. Okay, see, now you have attached something on the folio side. Now you should write some noting and sign to the section officer or to the concerned officer for getting the orders. For that, what you will be doing? You should write notings. In your office, there are two types of notings. One is green note, yellow note. The green note is something like which you can't alter once you are submitted to other user. Okay. Normally, you should ask me, yes, sir, while writing on the physical copy, you will write something and you will sign and send it off. Yes, that is a green note. Same thing as we write something on the paper, sign and send to the next officer. The same thing is green note here. Okay, why yellow note has been given? See, suppose if the section officer is busy and asked the section staff to write some note, okay, he may write something which may be edited multiple times by the next level. Okay, and it is finalized. Until it is finalized, it will be in yellow note. Okay, I will show you how to do it. Right? See, first of all, I am showing green note. To add a green note, you can write, say directly, you just click on add green note and you write whatever you want. And like this, a letter was received and I have written something. From there, I will send to the next level. That is over. Okay. It's over. Now, to write yellow note, you just click on yellow note here. See, this is yellow note, add yellow note button. Once you add yellow note button, it will show like this. Here you can write it down. Once, see, this yellow note writing, write notice and submit can be edited multiple times by different users till the note is finalized and converted to green note. See, here after writing yellow note, there are three options are there. One is edit, discard and confirm. Edit, we can write the notings, but in green note we cannot edit the notings. In yellow notings, we can edit the notings. Then the discard means, see, this note is full rubbish, we can directly discard. Discard is deleting it. When you say confirm, it will become a green note. Okay, these things, see, a accounts clerk can return to and write the note as SO, and after SO is seeing, say, yes, the note is good, then he will confirm it and it will become a green note. Okay. Sometimes notice can normally notice should not be edited. Whatever the staff should write, they should be allowed to write. If some mistakes are there, then for that purpose, this note, yellow note has been given. Okay. See, after writing a note, what will you do? You will write that, write as folio side, folio 123. Some important document is there. You will say that you will give a reference in the noting side simply that, see, so folio side 123. Letter is kept at folio 123, letter is kept at folio 125. For that, reference will be given, right? To give reference, there is an option in e-office that I will show you. See, the reference can be given in both ways, in folio side or correspondent side, or in notings, earlier notings. See, if the pages are, if in noting side there are 100 or 150 notings are there, in that, somewhere some 30th noting, some approval have been taken. Okay, if you want to highlight that approval of noting side, then also this reference can be given. Okay, that I will show you how to give it. See, if normally in folio side, if you want to give reference side, see here, I simply mentioned as copy in folio side. I should select it and highlight it while writing the noting itself. Okay, I should select and highlight it, and you can see there is a table here in the right side and right side top end. There is a table where you I have highlighted with red box, where you can select that, and as and when you select, you will be seeing a menu called refer correspondence. Here, if you say the page number, automatically the reference will be added to that noting. This is to add reference of correspondence or folio site. Okay. Here, the second one is reference to earlier notings. The procedure here is, first of all, you should select the select the text, and then here previous notings one tab is there which was highlighted. You can see it here, red line, red box. That previous noting should be selected, and then you should select the reference column, but tab the format. Then this refer noting by page number or by note number on the extra box, it will be displayed. On the display, you can give the page number or note number and then press OK. In this, you can give reference of earlier notings or earlier notings are on the same file. On the same file. These reference can be given only on the same file. That is very important. Okay, what happens in physical movement, we will be linking with other files, right? For other files, see, you can see the end. There is a button called attach, right? If any approvals are there in the other files, that should be downloaded and it can be attached here. That is the importance of link filing here. Whatever we can do physically, the same thing can be done in e-office also. Further, there is a button called attach here. I will show it in virtual, this one. And after giving writing note, you should send to the next concerned officer. Further, here there is a column called send. Once you say send, it will be addressed to address, set due date, action, priority, remarks, and there is a column called DSC sign and send, and without DSC send. These two columns, anything you can choose, but for authority and authenticative, you should only press select DSC sign and send. You can send to the next officer. Okay, as and when you press the DSC sign and send, it will ask one more password or PIN of your DSC signature and user PIN. This user PIN should be given, and as you should say login. Here, there will be a tick with name. That means it is DSC sign. Here, sign with DSC and send to CWM for approval. And here, and then the next is, he also has written a green note saying that approved, and it was signed by DSC and sent back to me. These two ticks are authorized. Means it is digitally signed. It means that on paper, how we sign the same thing, it is almost same. Okay, there is an option called pullback. What is pullback? Pullback is, suppose if I send a file to one person, and if he's on leave for some 30 days, okay, it will be on his table, and I should wait till he comes back. Okay, that is first one. I can't wait for 30 days, right? That's why what I will do is, there is an option called pullback in office. When I send a file or receipt to him, if he is not taking any action, I can pull back the file to me and I can send it to the other person. That option is available in e-office. This is the best option. With this, we can improve the efficiency of our department. Here, see, like a file. This how. See, suppose in e-office, if he has already read the file, it can't be pulled back. In both file section and also receipt section, it can be done. Now I will show you how it will be done. The in send folder of receipt section and also file section, in send folder, these are all the files which I sent to other person, other users. In the right and top, there is some button, a page with left arrow. If this is there, we can pull back that file from that person. From that user, means he didn't see the file yet. When we press the pullback button, reason for pullback will be asking. We should give the reason saying that the officer is on leave. Okay, and we can say, okay, it will come to your inbox, and then you can send it to other person. Okay, it can be used in other ways also. See, suppose you have written a noting which is wrong. Okay, you have written a green note which is wrong. You want to, you can't delete any file or note from that. But you can rewrite, means like by leaving that note, you can write the note again, taking excuse by pulling back the file from the officer. If he sees that, if he like, once the file was sent to him and if he sees the file, you can't pull it back. Okay? That is the main problem here. We can use in any way, pullback option. Like in hierarchical view also, that is also I will explain. In hierarchical view also means like if some files are pending with my down staff from long pending, I can pull back them and I can give it to some other person for taking action on it. I'll show it. See, now all physical files, when we receive physical files, what we used to do, we used to take all copies of all the files and we used to maintain parallel files, and then we will maintain one accounts file. In that we used to take orders. For that, what we should do, we used to take a lot of Xerox copies. Here, no need of any Xerox copies. We will take the whole, where you can download the executable file fully. We can download complete file or no, only notings or only correspondence or only draft for approvals, etc. Individually or completely for future reference and maintaining parallel files. How? See, here there is this tab, you can see where I have highlighted red in both sides, like a PDF one. As and when you press that, after opening the file, it will ask to generate or view PDF, complete files, notings, correspondence, and draft for approval. Okay, you should give a reason for that, why you are downloading. You simply say that for reference or for maintaining a parallel file in our department, in account department, or for something. You can give an option and then you can download, and as and when you download, you can browse and erase it and maintain a parallel file. After browse and erasing, you can put in a parallel file in. Okay? See, select option and to download and give the reasons and press OK and to the download file. The downloaded file should be browse and erase to attach to other files or create a parallel file in the most part. Okay, by this you can download any number of times till that file is with you. If not, even if it is in your sent folder, till your time, you can download many times. It's not a problem at all. Okay. Once you have taken approval on the noting side, after that you should put up a covering letter for signing of the officer. For putting up a covering letter, what is the procedure? Okay. See, in the noting side itself, after noting, there is a column called draft. In there, after draft, there is a column called create new draft. In that, create new draft. Once you press create new draft, this screen will be seen. In this screen, here, you can directly type the letter or you can copy paste from any Microsoft Word document, or if any document can be uploaded here. All the three ways this letter can be prepared. And after preparing the letter, the address metadata to be filled, means a two address metadata, to whom it should be sent, that communication address should be given here. Normally I have seen many of them are giving their address here, communication address. No, here we should give the two address. All mandatory fields are to be filled here, and once it is there, you should press save once the letter is final. After typing the letter, after giving the metadata, which metadata here? Two address. You went in and you press save. Okay, then it went to the officer. When the officer wants to view the letter and sees the letter, he will open his file and in the same draft thing, he will go for view draft option. Once he goes for view draft option, he will be seeing the letter. Okay, after seeing the letter, here he can do three things. One is preview for printing, and the other one is approve the letter and edit the letter if any corrections required. Once the corrections have been done, okay, and the approved, one letter number will be displayed on all the pages of the letter. On all the pages, the same letter will be, same letter number will be displayed. And then he has only approved the letter and then he should sign. For signing it, there are two options. One is TSC signature and the other one is custom signature. Okay. When he says TSC signature, by default, the signature will be on the left bottom. Left bottom. Or when you say it's custom signature, we can select the place where the signature to be, like this. When you press custom signature, the letter will be displayed here and this yellow box is there. You can select the yellow box and we can say DSC sign. As and when you say DSC sign, your password will be asked and it will be signed like this. If you say simply custom signature, it will be on the left bottom, same signature will be signed. Here I have signature, custom signature, so it is exactly on at signature place where I selected it was displayed. Okay. These things are very important for putting in this one. Okay. And see, as an officer, you should know how many files are pending with the ground level staff. For that, there is an option called hierarchical view. See, here where I highlighted, in inbox, if you go for hierarchical view, it will show my receipts and all the staff under you. When you click on one of the staff, it will show you what are the letters pending, what are the receipts pending with him. Okay. If he is not available in the office or if he is on leave or if he is not taking any action or if it is not pertaining to him, you can pull back. See here, the pullback option is available. As I told you, the letter with the left arrow is pullback. Pullback option is there. By clicking on pullback option, you can give the reason saying that it is pull up. And the files will be pulled up to your inbox and from there, you can take action on it. This hierarchical view can be seen by a SSO also. Means that supervisor will also have the hierarchical view. If one SSO is having some four clerks, all four clerks view can be seen. Without opening the staff's e-office menu, he can see from here how many files are pending with each staff. And if the staff is not available, he can deal from his side. For this hierarchical view is very important. Okay, why this is important means, previously what used to do is, there will be a register where whatever the files received, we will say that the file is received on so and so day. And after closing, means that after replying, we will give the reply to so and so on day. These two things will be shown on that file. Okay, and to manage that, a SSO can see all the staff under him and what are all the files pending with him, with the staff under him. And if the action was not taken by him, he can pull back to his level and he will be saying that yes, the file was pending with so and so and the early action may be taken at his end. Okay, with this, whatever basic data needed for working on your office, in this presentation, I have shown you. Okay, now I will show you a live demo, how to, it's only a presentation, this also you can do it, but I will show you a live demo, how to deal on your office. Any doubts, please? You can chat, it's not a problem. Sai has asked one question, sir, can DOC sent in one file can be used in another file where the same reference is to be used? Yes, sir, only thing is you should download that. The DOC can be downloaded and we can browse and erase again and we can attach to any number of files. Sir, some Dell iPhone, some question is, please explain DSC signature once. How to attach a file to new file? Okay. Sir, I already showed you, I am again showing how to attach a file to a new file. Okay. You can open a file, sir, by creating, I'll show it to you once. See, you can open a file by creating new file in the files column. After that, to attach a receipt to that, see, I already told you, you should go to DOC, that is table of contents. Okay, and then there will be a button called attach. From there, already browser directs something, browser directs or inbox folder, receipts inbox folder will be there. You can select one of that and you can say attach. And as and when you say attach, it will come to your folio site. Hope I cleared your doubt. I already put kept it presentation. You can see it once. How can attach? Same thing. You can attach. Normally, it should be converted into a PDF and you should attach. How can we attach an Excel sheet? But the reply is, Excel should be taken into a PDF. See, when you print, when an Excel sheet to be printed, if you say that it is to be printed as PDF, it will be printed to PDF and then only we can attach. Without DSC, can we send a noting, sir? If you don't have DSC, okay, if not, DSC is compulsory. The file will move without DSC, it's not a problem. But when you have a DSC, it will have some authenticity that you have signed and sent. Please show a file and how to make your file and make observations. Yeah, I will show it to you virtually, sir. One second. And can we access previous year send file? Yeah, you can download and access, sir. It's not a problem. It will be in your send folder. It's not a problem at all. Ajay Singhia. Sir, one second, excuse me.
Sir, in class. నేను చూసుకున్నాను మధ్యాహ్నంలో బయట.
సార్, వాట్ ఈస్ నాట్ అవైలబుల్ సార్? ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ అవైలబుల్. సార్, వెంకటేష్ జీ, క్యాన్ వీ కాప్ సీ దట్ that thing is, again, you should see, when the e-office is implemented, all the previous year's files are scanned and kept with us. All section officers are asked to create PDFs of earlier files. Sir, please unmute, sir. Akshu, sir, please unmute, sir.
Sir, participants have given option for unmuting.
Sir, I am Neelam from Western Railway.
Okay.
Actually, whatever file I have generated, created and sent previous year, I am unable to access it, sir.
You are in the same seat?
Yes, sir.
Oh, then it will be in your send file, send folder.
It is not available, sir. That is why I am asking, you know, previous year, whatever I have sent to other people, no, to see what I had sent or some kind of reference, no. Because, sir, we have been working in a lockdown. So, half of the time we had been working from home and half of the time we have been working from office. So, to have the data, no, sometimes to do a back reference what we had sent, which I tried, but somehow I am unable to.
Madam, I want to clear something to you. In e-office, nobody can delete any file or which is created earlier, okay? Nobody has the right to delete any file. only thing is suppose
what I'm trying to tell you, sir. See, like, maybe there is an option for checking previous year financial, and I am not aware of it. That's why I was asking.
No, no. Madam, what I'm saying is that you just contact your admin, okay?
Okay, sir.
Why? Because something happened to me, which I will explain to you. See, there is a rotation is going on, ma'am. See, for 15 days, I am working as SSO, and for other 15 days, some other person is working as SSO for same seat. Okay, for same seat. Okay, as and when I told you, today I am SSO MNP. What they will do is, in IPAS, my name will be given as SSO MNP. Tomorrow, after 15 days, the other person will be given as SSO MNP. Some files will be with you and the other files will be with him. Thus, two accounts will be created.
No, sir, I have been working on the same thing.
Even if you dealt it, you can ask your admin. Okay, that admin can see, can search that file, here it is. It's not a problem. You just contact your GAIT, just give the reference of that file and he can search and give it to you. It's not a problem. Nobody can delete the file and it will not go anywhere.
It's a question of deleting, sir. I'm not which, wherever it was needed to go, it has reached, they have taken, the work has been done. But, like, no, this year, if I want a back reference, I thought, let me check. Then I tried all the possible ways to check, but I couldn't trace what I have sent. Means that option is there, that's why I was asking. Is there somewhere where we can put the year 2020 and then check if it is available? That way I was asking. Do you understand?
No.
No other way. Because okay. See, sir, one more thing I will tell you. See, when we have to attach a previous year file, no, then that option is there. If the file has been created in 2021, it is readily available. But if the file has been created in 2020, we have to select that 2020, then only those files are for attaching the letter, it comes forward. I hope I am clear.
No, you are clear, madam, but that is not that option of clearing, like selecting year wise. I don't think it is there in your office. Anyway, ma'am, just take my number take my number and call me once. I will just refer into it and come back to you, okay? My number, I am just giving it in chat box, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you so much. I understood, ma'am. You know, your send if you file, what you have sent to others. Means sometimes you have to be specific, they have asked for information and you prepare and you send it to them, it is then done and there with. But if I want to search it for 2020 now, I am not getting those files. Means in the sent option.
Okay, ma'am. Anyway, I'll just call me after that, ma'am. I will just refer to it and come back to you.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. My number is there, you can check it, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. But browse devices are not available. Sir, you can ask me directly the question, sir. It's not a problem. See, attached files can't be sent to multiple people. You should attach every time. Okay? Only two address will be taken for attached multiple. This one, for other people, it can't be sent. If you want to see, like, writing a letter to main address and copy to. For copy to, you will be not sending all the attachments. Okay? To main person only, all the attachments will be going in receipt section. But browse receipts are not able once forward to other. Yes, you should forward. See, once you keep it in file or once you send to other person, you should browse and erase every time. If not, you should go to send folder and once you forward it to one person, the same can be sent to another person also. Sai, I think I replied to you. Hello? Any doubts, please?
Yes, sir.
Yes, please.
DSC is compulsory for MD staff.
MD means?
DSC, digital signature.
Yeah.
Is it compulsory for every group?
For everyone. Yeah, sabko chahiye. DSC sabko chahiye. Kuch update karna chahiye, sign karke bhejna chahiye, to DSC sabko chahiye. Even for accounts, DSC. required.
Hello sir.
हाँ बताइए.
सर ये मैं जब ड्राफ्ट करता हूँ
okay.
उसमें अदर देन मतलब एक्सप्लोरर में करते हैं तो सही रहता है सर, और क्रोम और दूसरे
सेटिंग्स करना पड़ता है पहले
तो सर उसमें मशीन लैंग्वेज बन जाता है दूसरा ब्राउजर में सर.
एक्चुअली सर कोई कौन सा ब्राउजर यूज किया तो भी कुछ प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, लेकिन उसका सेटिंग्स करना पड़ता है. मैक्सिमम मोज़िला यूज़ करो, नहीं तो गूगल क्रोम यूज़ करो.
तो गूगल क्रोम में सर वही मशीन लैंग्वेज का कैसे सेटिंग करेंगे वो ड्राफ्ट जो भी ड्राफ्ट करते हैं डाटा वो
मशीन लैंग्वेज है सर, थोड़ा इधर उधर जाएगा बस. मशीन लैंग्वेज का कुछ नहीं है वो. देखो आपने राइट हैंड पे रखा है लेकिन वो राइट हैंड पे नहीं होता, वो प्रॉब्लम हम भी फेस किया. लेकिन हमने क्या कर रहे हैं कि वंस द लेटर इज फाइनल हम पीडीएफ पे अटैच करके साइन कर रहे हैं, इसलिए वो ठीक से जा रहा है हमारे इस तरफ.
हाँ हाँ सर पीडीएफ में अगर करेंगे तो वो सही होता है.
हम वही कर रहे हैं. देखो लेटर वर्ड में टाइप किया तो प्रिंटिंग द लेटर वो लेटर ठीक से नहीं आ रहा है, इसलिए हम क्या कर रहे हैं लेटर पीडीएफ में फाइल सेट करने के बाद हम अपलोड कर रहे हैं ई ऑफिस पे और डिजिटली साइन कर रहे हैं हम.
जी जी सर.
सर हाँ बताइए
सर. वो दूसरा रहता है सिग्नेचर दूसरे पेज में आ जाता है सर
वो, ये इसलिए कस्टम सिग्नेचर बोल के मैंने कस्टम सिग्नेचर बोल के एक ऑप्शन है. आपको इधर चाहिए उधर सेलेक्ट करके डीएससी साइन बल पे प्रेस किया है तो उधर आएगा.
अच्छा सर. और तीसरा इशू ये है सर, ड्राफ्ट में मान ले हमने चार पेज इशू ये किया डाला और चारों पेज पे हम साइन करना चाहते हैं
तब नहीं होगा. एक सिग्नेचर आएगा चाहिए तो तब आप चार ड्राफ्ट सिंगल पेज चार ड्राफ्ट बना के भेजना पड़ता है.
हाँ सो सिंगल मतलब हर पेज पे ऑप्शन अभी तक कोई ये ऑफिस में नहीं है.
इसलिए बोल रहे हैं वन समय अप्रूव करने के बाद सभी पेजेस को एक लेटर नंबर आएगा.
हाँ तो सर तब
वो लेटर नंबर से हम पहचानते हैं कि सभी एक ही लेटर है वो.
अच्छा सर मतलब ये ऑप्शन
आपने एक तीन पेज का लेटर मुझे फिजिकल कॉपी पुटअप किया, मैं सभी पेज पे लेटर साइन नहीं करूंगा, मैंने फाइनल पेज ही लेटर साइन करूंगा राइट.
हाँ
लेकिन उधर क्या होगा तीन पेज को मैं एक ही स्टैंप करके रखूंगा.
जी सर. पर सर दूसरी इशू है जैसे एस्टीमेट हम लोग वेट करने के लिए डालते हैं ये ऑफिस में तो सर एस्टीमेट लास्ट पेज पे साइन होता है और एस्टीमेट में पांच पेज का है तो सारे एग्जीक्यूटिव की साइन रहती है सारे पेज पे, पर मेरा ऑफिसर अगर हम एक सिंगल ड्राफ्ट बनाएंगे तो लास्ट पेज पे ही साइन होता है.
आपने एक एक पेज को पीडीएफ बना के बेस ड्राफ्ट पे अप्रूव कर दो हो जाएगा सभी.
हाँ बिल्कुल बिल्कुल सर ऐसा में तो हो जाएगा.
Yes.
ऐसा अगर सजेस्ट कर दे सर कि सभी पे हो जाए मतलब ई ऑफिस में हो जाए ऐसा व्यवस्था तो
नहीं सर. अभी हम ई ऑफिस क्यों यूज कर रहे हैं कि पेपर में यूज करना बोल के.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल.
इसलिए आपने पीडीएफ अपलोड करना ड्राफ्ट में बहुत इजी है आपको. आज पेज का तो भी आपके एक एक पेज ड्राफ्ट बनाया ड्राफ्ट बनाया तो भी कुछ प्रॉब्लम नहीं है ऑफिसर को.
ओके ओके.
पासवर्ड साइन पासवर्ड देना का नहीं है, एक बार पासवर्ड दे दिया हर पेज पे
डिजिटल
सिग्नेचर
मल्टीपल सिग्नेचर
डीएससी सिग्नेचर कैसे साइन करना है बस.
यस यस
कैन यू सी माय स्क्रीन.
यस यस
सी लाइक मैडम वंस द लेटर इज पुट अप बाय द स्टाफ देयर इज अ कॉल कॉल्ड ड्राफ्ट आफ्टर दैट व्यू ड्राफ्ट. ओके
ओके
देयर वंस द आई प्रेस द व्यू ड्राफ्ट आई कैन सी द लेटर हियर राइट ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड.
Yes.
On the right hand bottom, there are three options, preview, approve and edit. If I want to edit, I will edit. And then if I want to approve, I will approve. Once it is approved, on the top of the page, one letter number will be issued and it will be common to all the pages of that letter.
Okay.
Once that is there, okay, I should sign it right. I only approved now. For signing it, there are two options. One is DSC signature and other one is custom signature.
Yes.
Okay. When I press DSC signature, at the bottom of the page, left side, automatically my name will be displayed. On the last page, last page bottom, okay?
Yes, yes.
And for the other, if I want to sign in the exact place, I should press custom signature. Once I press custom signature, one more window will be displayed. In that, I can select the place where I can sign. See this yellow box you can see on the screen, that is the place where I can sign. And here I can press the DSC sign. Once I press the DSC sign, it will see where I selected, that there itself I signature. Okay, letter was digital left. Concerned this place, I can select in custom signature. Normal DSC sign, it will sign at the bottom of every page.
Sir, one more question, sir.
Yes.
Sir. Sir, multiple DSC signature, जैसे दो ऑफिसर का एक ही पेज पे सर हो सकता है, ये ऑप्शन है? जैसे एग्जीक्यूटिव का, मतलब एग्जीक्यूटिव का ऑफिसर भी साइन किया और फिर हमारा भी ऑफिसर उसी पे डिजिटल साइन है सर?
ट्राई नहीं किया, लेकिन मैंने ट्राई करके बता दूंगा आपको, अभी तक मैं ट्राई नहीं किया, कर सकता है, क्योंकि आप सोच कर सकते हैं उसमें कुछ प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, मल्टीपल सिग्नेचर हो सकता है।
तो सर ये कैसे सर, हम जानकारी चाहिए सर।
एक बार आप एक काम करो।
जी सर।
आप ऑलरेडी आपने लेटर साइन करने के बाद उसको डाउनलोड करके एक बार ड्राफ्ट में आप अप्रूव अटैच करो।
जी जी।
हाँ, तब हो जाएगा।
अच्छा सर, दूसरा
साइन लेटर ड्राफ्ट और एक बार अटैच करो सर।
दूसरी एक इशू और आता है सर, वो जैसे डाउनलोड करते हैं तो सर कभी कभी वो साइन ही गायब हो जाता है पेज पे।
नहीं, गायब नहीं होगा सर, वो आप डाउनलोड करता है ना, वो सिस्टम पे डीएससी क्या बोलते हैं उसको, रिकॉग्नाइज करने का फॉर्मेट नहीं होगा, उस सिस्टम पे वो नहीं होगा, इसलिए वो नहीं दिखेगा।
हाँ, तो इसीलिए सर वो जैसे डाउनलोड किए तो देखते हैं कि अरे पेज में प्रिंट में साइन ही नहीं आया, ऐसा भी इशू होता है हमें।
आप भी Adobe PDF Viewer से देखो, उस पे होगा जरूर।
Adobe PDF Viewer
बोल के होगा।
यस सर,
उससे देखो, जरूर होगा। ये डाउट मुझे भी आया, लेकिन सेम डॉक्यूमेंट दूसरी सिस्टम पे ओपन किया तो आ रहा है।
ओके सर,
ठीक है।
जी सर, थैंक यू।
यस these are the things required, ma'am. We need for implementation of the office, we need RailNet and digital signature and Gmail mail ID and DSC service signer and Java 32-bit, ma'am. Okay, in the chat box, document by name, PDF update, e-office update. Okay, with that e-office update, you can download the DSC service signer and also the Java 32-bit from that. Okay, if you don't have DSC and Govin mail ID, for that also I have application format and the procedure. I will be giving it to Sitara. From there you can collect it, it's not a problem. Means like if you don't have DSC and you didn't get DSC, for that the CP is providing digital signatures, for that application format is there with attachments, what are the documents to be presented. And also for NIC mail ID also, you can approach the nodal officer or the admin of your unit. He will provide you the Govin mail ID and also DSC signature format too.
Okay.
Thank you. Any other issues, please? Shall we go for virtually? Shall we see virtually once?
सर फाल मोमेंट कहाँ से पता चलेगा?
क्या क्या
फाल मोमेंट, कौन सा फाल कहाँ पर? दो चार महीना बाद हम फाइल को सर्च करेंगे तो उसका मोमेंट कैसे पता चलेगा सर, कहाँ पर वो फाइल है?
आपने भेजा वो सेंड फोल्डर पे जाके देखिए, उत्तर उत्तर मिलेगा आपको। आपने किसको भेजा वो तक उत्तर तक मालूम हो जाएगा।
ये फील्ड इंस्पेक्टर्स कैसे यूज कर सकते हैं इसको? DIS, ISS
रिक्वायरमेंट है तो आपको DSC दे दिया होगा सर। हमारा SCR पे है तो इन दिया सर हम ऐसे, क्योंकि ISS को भी दिया, IMMS पे DSC यूज कर रहा
है। अच्छा, ऑन रिक्वायरमेंट ओनली इट कैन बी यूज सर।
यस यस सर। ये फिर सी आपने कितने लेटर्स भेजते हैं सर? DIS एंड ISS मैक्सिमम। देखो आप हेडक्वार्टर्स ISS अभी स्टाफ डिस्पोजल करने के लिए और स्टॉक शीट क्लोज करने के लिए नोटिस पुट अप करना पड़ता है, इसलिए वो लोग को हम दिया था इधर। सर हेडक्वार्टर्स ISS होगा ना सर, वो स्टाफ डिस्पोज करने के लिए या स्टॉक शीट क्लोज करने के लिए नोटिस पुट अप करते हैं सर, इसलिए वो लोग को हम ई ऑफिस अकाउंट दिया, ऐसा ही NIC मेल ID और DSC भी दिया था। हेलो
They should approach some railnet
in railway station or in some offices near to them.
It can be through railnet only.
Yes, sir. It can be through railnet only. On other broadband or BSNL broadband or any other broadband, it can't be used. The e-office will not work.
Means, but the field inspectors are not able to use it.
Yes, 100%. That is the main problem in implementation of e-office. Suppose if I go home and I want to clear the files, I can't do it. Because I am staying in a private house.
Okay, right, right.
Any other doubts, please? Yeah, bataiye.
सर एस्टिमेट एसक्यूटी द्वारा भेजा गया जो एस्टिमेट है उसमें करेक्शन करना है सर, और करेक्शन करके फिर उसको अटैच करना है, तो ये कैसे होगा सर? जैसे कुछ करेक्शन करना है अपने को।
नहीं सर, नया एस्टिमेट एग्जीक्यूटिव से लेना पड़ता है। आप कुछ करेक्शन
ऑलरेडी साइन करके आएगा ना एस्टिमेट, लेकिन उसके उसी के एस्टिमेट पर सर कुछ करेक्शन करना है अपने आप, कुछ कैलकुलेशन मिस्टेक है या कुछ और
भी है? कौन सा फॉर्मेट पे है?
PDF में सर,
PDF
जो अटैच रहता है ऑल में, जो सर जो ऑल साइड में जो अटैच रहता है सर, CP साइड में
वही है सर। PDF में तो आपने उसको एडिट नहीं कर सकते है ना,
तो फिर क्या एग्जीक्यूटिव को रिटर्न करना पड़ेगा सर?
जरूर रिटर्न करना पड़ता है, नहीं तो उससे एक्सेल शीट लेके एक्सेल शीट को करेक्ट करके उसको PDF बना के कर सकता है।
ओके ठीक है सर।
ठीक है
जी जी
ओके। अदर डाउट्स प्लीज
सर। एनी नोट इन ग्रीन फील्ड Can
yeah. yeah, it can be pulled back, ma'am, but you can't edit that. You should write a fresh note in the green note format, that's all, before sending to other officers. You can pull back the file, ma'am, the total file you can pull back, but you can't edit the green note once it is written because it will be not the same. Okay, it is not a yellow note to be edited. Okay, what you should do is, you should simply say that the earlier note may be forgotten, you can write a new fresh note and for approval, for getting the approval or orders. Any other doubts, please? I'll be showing this see the, this is the first screen of, I think that you are able to see the office, okay?
सर
हाँ बताइए
सर ये इसमें रिसाइकल बिन है तो उसका सर वो क्या कोई फाइल डिलीट करेंगे तो उसमें आ जाएगा क्या
डिलीट करने ऑप्शन किधर है पहले
हाँ डिलीट का तो ऑप्शन ही नहीं है सर तो रिसाइकल
कभी भी फाइल डिलीट नहीं कर सकते आपने
तो अच्छा सर हाँ ये तो
आपको डिलीट ही नहीं कराता तो आपने रिसाइकल बिन क्या ढूंढेगा नहीं होगा उधर
अच्छा सर और एक मीनू आ रहा है सर माइग्रेट फाइल ये इसका क्या यूज होता है सर माइग्रेट फाइल का
माइग्रेट फाइल और ईमेल डाइजेशन दोनों एक ही सी सपोज नॉट इन रेलवे इन अदर डिपार्टमेंट्स ईमेल इज आल्सो यूज्ड फॉर मूवमेंट ऑफ फाइल्स
तो ये सर अभी यूज में है मतलब वर्किंग में है ये माइग्रेट
वो ये बता रहा हूँ मैंने कुछ फिजिकल फाइल्स को माइग्रेट कर सकता है बोला तो सर आपके पीडीएफ फाइल्स आपके पास है उसको नया फाइल्स बनाना चाहिए तो यू कैन कन्वर्ट देम टू ई फाइल्स ओके सम टैब्स व्हिच आर देयर इन योर ऑफिस आर नॉट रिक्वायर्ड एट ऑल फॉर रेलवे वर्किंग
ओके ओके सर
ओके आई थिंक यू आर एबल टू सी द फर्स्ट लॉगिन स्क्रीन सी हियर यू कैन सी द आईडिया scr.eofficerail.railnet.gov.in ओके गिविंग दिस एड्रेस यू कैन लॉग इन Okay, and as I told you, this is the login screen, and here the login ID you can omit @gov.in, and you are directly giving the login ID only up to your name, and you are giving your password and entering into the office. Once you entered, this will be the first screen, and as I told you, here you just check whether it is on your name, Udaykiran Vora, and you see the profile whether you are logged in your account or not.
Okay.
Because in railways, what happens is one system will be used for a lot of users. We think that it is like our login and we will be working on it. But after some time, we will be knowing that it is not our ID. Okay? Because of auto save and password, everyone's login can be opened in any system. And after that, as I told you, we can go on e-file or file management system to go into the e-office screen.
Okay, sir. सर वन मोर क्वेश्चन सर ये एसएमएस अलर्ट ऑप्शन अभी सर यूज में है या नहीं सर
या यूज पे है आपको आप रख सकते हैं वो सेटिंग अभी मैं आपका स्क्रीन पे मैं सेटिंग्स बोल के एक ऑप्शन है देखो मैं दिखा रहा हूँ उधर जाके मेंटर किया तो एसएमएस ऑप्शन आएगा आपका यूजर अकाउंट ओपन करके सेटिंग्स ओपन करके प्रेफरेंसेस बोल के एक होगा
डीएससी में सेटिंग ऑप्शन मेनू में
डीएससी नीचे डीएससी का नीचे सेटिंग्स ऑप्शन है उस पे प्रेफरेंसेस बोल के एक है उधर प्रेफरेंसेस क्लिक किया तो
यस सर
ओके अलर्ट सेटिंग्स पे इधर ईमेल एसएमएस बोथ नन बोल के है
यस सर हां
इधर एसएमएस बोल के आप क्लिक किया तो आपका फोन नंबर इधर टाइप करके सेव किया तो ऑटोमेटिकली एज एंड व्हेन समबडी कोई आपको फाइल भेजा या रिसीव भेजा तो आपका अलर्ट आएगा
ओके ओके सर ओके
ठीक है आप देख सकते हैं मेरा स्क्रीन पे वो
हाँ मैं भी खोल लिया हूँ सर उसको देख रहा हूँ इसमें अपना मोबाइल नंबर डाल के सर और ईमेल और एसएमएस बोथ या ओनली एसएमएस करके सर सेव कर दें
हाँ कर सकते हैं ऐसा
ओके ओके सर
हेलो सर हेलो
Sir,
I am from ICF.
Okay.
Sir, if we can send one letter to multiple officers through receipt, sir.
Yes, we can send. Suppose, see, in receipts, once I browse and iris, right?
Okay.
And once I browse and iris, and only once I can send to one user. After sending, I can go to send folder.
Okay.
This see. Now, this once I browse and sign to Mujhpa Kiran, now the same thing I can take it here, click and send. I can send to many again.
Oh, okay.
In, from send folder, you can send it to many, any times.
Okay. Okay, sir, okay. And same time, not send to multiple officers.
Yeah, you can use 2 and CC also.
Sir, how to get the movement details? Only two officers.
See, suppose you are sending the same document to 10 people, 10 different movements will be available with you.
but
you can't in 10 different moments. It will be shown in 10 times in the same folder.
Okay. Okay, sir. Okay.
Because file is only one file. But if the file is with me, it will be with me only. But yes, in receipts, you are taking Xerox of 10 copies and you are giving to 10 people, right?
Okay.
10 people, that we can't do anything, right?
Yes,
that's all.
Okay.
Other doubts, please? Chalo, now I will show you how to draw the tiles. See, as I told you, this is the first screen of e-office. Here, there is a column called receipts. In receipts, there is option for browse and diaries, inbox, email diarization, created, sent, closed by me. See, if you want to browse and diaries something, you should go to receipt section and then browse and diaries. In browse and diaries, see it's blank and you should go and click the upload file. Press the upload file. From there, you can upload any document. Just I am uploading this MHA order. Okay, as and when it is uploaded, it will be the size, maximum size is only up to 20 MB and the format is PDF. It is uploaded now. The document contains of 5 pages and the totally it is uploaded. Once uploaded, we should do the metadata. Metadata is only mandatory marks. Here delivery mode and correspondent type should be selected and then ministry, department name and these to be fields.
बता तो रहे हैं पर यहाँ पर
डाउट है तो पूछो, डाउट है तो डाउट बोल के बता देना, कुछ प्रॉब्लम नहीं है
सर. वो
हाँ
सर, ये मोबाइल नंबर डालने नहीं दे रहा सर इसमें, ऑप्शन वाले में वहाँ पे क्लिक हो रहा है पर वहाँ पे ऑप्शन नंबर नहीं डालने दे रहा सर.
आपने एक बार एडमिन से कांटेक्ट करो, आपका एडमिन से.
ओके.
सी एवरी टाइम देयर इज नोट हियर टू फिल द मेटाडेटा. मेटाडेटा क्या होता है कि एवरी टाइम नो नीड ऑफ फिलिंग इट. ओके, व्हाट यू शुड डू इज वंस यू गिव द फुल डिटेल्स.
यस सर.
एंड देयर इज अ बॉक्स हियर ऐड टू एड्रेस बुक. यू कैन सी कांटेक्ट डिटेल्स हियर. वंस यू से ऐड टू एड्रेस बुक, as and when you type your name, you will be having the option of selecting it. See, one, I just typed in the name and I got two options. One is of Rail Neelam address and the other one is of Tirupati address. Because I am working in Tirupati address, and I selected the Tirupati address. And by default, Ministry of Railways accounts and all my details have
been
saved here. Okay, no need of typing every time. After that, just go to main category and select. This is a miscellaneous document, so I just selected a miscellaneous document. I will simply give the name, MHK, order, and there are two options here, whether to generate and generate and send. As I already explained, generate is only to keep it in our file or to send to some other user later, and generate and send is the option for sending it to the other user immediately. Now itself, I can send it to other user. Hello, now sir. I want to keep it in file, so I just click it, generate.
Okay, sir.
Okay. See, any doubts can be there, can be given in chat box. Okay.
Hello.
Yes, please.
हाँ सर, मुझे ये पूछ रहा है कि अभी जब कांटेक्ट डिटेल में था तो नाम में अगर मेरा नाम सर्च नहीं होता है, आपने बताया यहाँ कांटेक्ट डिटेल.
नहीं, और एक बात बताइए प्लीज.
हाँ, तो उसमें डेजिग्नेशन जब डालेंगे तो उसमें नाम अगर सेलेक्ट नहीं करते हैं तो उसमें डेजिग्नेशन नहीं चल पाता.
सर, आपने दो अक्षर टाइप किया तो ऑटोमेटिकली वो दो अक्षर का सर्च उधर दिखेगा सर, सभी नाम दिखेगा, उस पे आपने एक सेलेक्ट करना पड़ता है.
नहीं सर, वो कॉन्टेक्ट डिटेल में मेरा नाम जिसे उस लिस्ट में नहीं है जो अपन सर्च करते हैं, तो मैनुअल नहीं उसमें हो सकता है कि मेरा नाम उसके बाद डेजिग्नेशन में मेरा डेजिग्नेशन नहीं आता.
वो आपने आपका एडमिट से एडिट करने के लिए बताया है सर. मेरा से देखो, आपने अभी सी इफ आई एम सेंडिंग समथिंग टू, अभी देखो सेंड पे आपने इधर आपका नाम नहीं आ रहा है, वो नहीं आ रहा है ना
यहाँ पे. नहीं सर, ब्राउजर डायरी में जो नीचे.
हाँ, ब्राउजर डायरी पे
जी यहाँ पे.
हाँ,
यहाँ नेम.
हाँ,
नेम में मेरा नाम डाला था राजीव कुमार. तो उसमें जो आते हैं आपको सेलेक्ट करने वाले ऑप्शन,
हाँ
उसमें मेरा नाम अगर नहीं है तो यहाँ पे डेजिग्नेशन
नहीं, पहले पहले बार आपने ऑटो एड्रेस बुक करना है, एक बार
जी
फर्स्ट टाइम ऑटो एड्रेस बुक करना है, उसके बाद ही आएगा।
ओके सर, उसके बाद एड टू एड्रेस करेंगे तो इसमें एडिट कर सकते हैं, अपना नाम डाल सकते हैं और डेजिग्नेशन।
चलो आपने अभी अभी आपका कुछ मिस्टेक हो गया ऐड टू एड्रेस डालने के बाद, और एक बार पूरा डिटेल्स डाल के ऐड टू एड्रेस करो, नेक्स्ट टाइम नया ऑप्शन आएगा।
ओके थैंक यू।
ओके सी नाउ वी हैव ऑलरेडी ब्राउज्ड डायरेक्टली दिस मिनिस्ट्री और एमएचए ऑर्डर, इट विल बी इन रिसीट्स क्रिएटेड ऑप्शन, यू कैन सी हियर this is what I browse and diaries, right? Now this document can be sent to any user, or I can put it in some other file. Okay, here if I can send, simply saying that I can send to some person. Okay, now sir, by suppose I want to send to my friend my AA here, I'm just typing his name, he's Red Ramlu, and I just type that if I say send, it will go to his account. Okay, and again and because it was sent to his account, I can't find it in my created folder, but I can find it in my sent folder. See, just now I sent one to Mr. Reddy Ramlu and sender is Uday Kiran Bora. It's the MHA order. You can see it here. If I want to send the same document to other person, what I will do is, I will just pick it here and I will say again send. Now I want to send to some other person by name called Pushpa Kiran. Okay. What I will do is, I will just type Pushpa Kiran name and I will select and send. See, without browsing and direct the same document, I have sent the document to two persons. In the same way, I can send to many. Suppose now what I understood is, they didn't see the file even after 3-4 days. Okay, now I got a doubt whether he is coming to office and opening the office or not. I thought, okay, I will put that in. See, there is a pullback option here. Okay, I can pull back, say pull back and reason that the employee is absent. Employee is absent for a long time. And I will simply say pull back. Once I say pull back, by default, it will come to my inbox. See, till now, my inbox is empty. And now, what I pulled off, pull back from Pushpa Kiran has come to my inbox. From there, I can send it to some other person for taking necessary action. Okay, and now see that's now the same document want to be kept in some other file. See, here there is an option called put in a file. If I say put in a file, it will ask, see, whether to in existing files or create a new file. I will say create new file, create non-SFS. I already told you what is non-SFS. Non-FS is non-single file system. When I say non-single file system, which Vinba I already showed you, here by default these fields have been filled by my admin. I just selecting it because it is a miscellaneous file. I will simply say that miscellaneous, and I will give you name for the file MHA, and I will say continue working. Okay, receipt inserted a newly created file, and it's saying okay. As and when it say okay, one file is created and completed. Here it is for saying that I should go to file section and created completed section. See, I am going to file section. In file section, created and completed. Once they completed, a new file will be here. That is, the file name I already showed you is MHA. Is Ministry of Home Affairs. That's what the file name given by me. And I am opening that file now. See, as and when I open the file, because the five-page document already is there, it came into the right side of the folio side, right side, and there is an option here. One is add green note and the other one is add yellow note. Okay, if I want to write a permanent note here to the officer, I will click on add green note, and here for writing a note, the window appears and we can type anything here, writing in the note, and we can send it to other person. Okay, here there is an option called quick noting. And quick noting is here Hindi and English orders both we can use. Like here abolition of post approved, unmoved. Okay, as amended or as discussed, chacha ke anusar, as proposed. Sabhi idhar hai, we can directly select that selected. Okay, वो option भी है. Means like short notes which you not need not type. You can go for quick noting and we can use the noting from here. Okay, once the noting has been completed, you can send add a letter here, draft letter here, or if not, we can directly send a file with the noting to the next concerned officer or supervisor. For that, you should press send. Once you press send, what happens is here there will be two address where you can directly type the two address of the to the next other user. Okay, here see, like as and when I type the name, I am getting the option of that name. Okay, here I can show you something. Like see here, this you are able to see here. I highlighted that all reporting officers, subordinates, internal and preferred list. This is also important thing. All means Thousand Railway headquarters, all employees names will be displayed with Gopal Naik. And reporting officer is the officer whom I am reporting. And subordinate means the persons who are under me. And internal means the file has already moved. Means suppose the file has moved from five places and came to me. Okay, five levels and came to me. Only then five levels will be coming. And preferred list can be given in the settings. Like user group here, I can give the preferred list. Only the preferred list will be available here. Okay. By default, what I do is I give all, and I will select a name here. From all list of SCR headquarters, I can the name which I have given will be selected, will be highlighted, and then I will select that. Here there are two things. One is notify by email or SMS. If I click SMS, then only he will be notified with SMS that this file was sent to him. In the same way, set due date. This due date before this date, the action should be taken, and also the action for forward or for approval, approved for information seen, put on again, please discuss. All these things will be readily available here. We can use, and priority also we can use out today, most immediate and immediate. Based on this, allow will be changed in the inbox of his folder, and with that he will take action. And if any remarks to be added, we can add the remarks here. And it can be signed without signature PSC or with PSC as per our requirement. But 100%, if any official file movement is available, is there, then we should use only DSC sign and send. Once you press DSC sign and send, by default, what happens is the PIN will be asked. If your DSC is added, means attached to your system, this PIN, it's asking my PIN. And as and when I give my PIN and say login, it will go from my inbox to his inbox, and the file will be in my send folder. See, now at present I have sent him file by name MHA, and it is my send folder file name to MHA to Mr. P. Gopal Naik at on 2/7/21 at 12:15:56 hours. Okay, what happened here is, see, here till date he didn't see it, means because I sent it, now he didn't see. Here also same option, I can pull back the file from him. All other files have been seen by the other users, so these other files I can't pull back. Only the file which I have sent now is not seen by him, that file only can be pulled back by me. Okay, and now what I want to show is, see, because I have digitally signed, here you can see my sign is fully signed and with a green tick. This is very important, means it is officially signed. If I am not sending, now what I will show you is, I am pulling back this option. If I am not signing, if I am sending the same file, without signature, how it will, that I will show. Now I pull it back, pull back that file to me. And it was in my inbox. You can see it is in files, inbox. Here it is. See, now I am sending to other person without signature. That also I can show. Okay, now I am adding a green note for process, and I am sending to other person. Yeah. here now I am sending without signature. See, because I am sending without DSC, it didn't ask any password. Directly it will be in my send folder. See, it, and see, this is I have set to render download at 12:57 p.m. And it's showing pullback option because he said to save. Now I am showing it to you. See, here the tick mark is not there. Means it is not digitally signed. If it digitally signed, I will, it will be audited you, and for all approvals and sanctions, digital sign is compulsory. That's what I want to say. And here the main option is, I want to show it is for officers at least. This hierarchical view, this is very important because here my files, whatever the files the pending with the staff can be seen here. See, in my file section, I am selecting AB Funshaker. With this, I will be knowing how many files are pending with him. Okay, now because he is not taking any action on it, I can pull up that file to me and I can send it to other person for taking necessary action. Okay? Any other doubts, please?
Hello?
Yes, please.
सर मैंने SMS में जाके SMS अलर्ट पे क्लिक
किया। ओके, SMS में जाके नंबर एडिट किया ना?
सर, हर एक फाइल के लिए मिरर फाइल बनाना पड़ेगा क्या?
क्या हुआ?
हर एक फाइल के लिए सर अलग अलग मिरर फाइल बनाना पड़ेगा सर।
अलग अलग
मिरर फाइल? सर
मिरर फाइल क्यों बनाना पड़ता है? क्योंकि देखो, आपने अकाउंट्स में काम करना चाहिए तो आपने एक्सिट फाइल में डील किया सब कुछ, तब आपके पास फाइल नहीं होगा ना?
नहीं सर,
नहीं होगा। देखो आप, देखो अभी फिजिकली क्या हो रहा है, आपको एक फाइल आ रहा है, ऐसा वाला फाइल आ रहा है, एग्जीक्यूटिव से ऐसा वाला एक फाइल आ रहा है, आप उसी पे अपलोड बोल के लिख के भेज दिया, वो फाइल एग्जीक्यूटिव के पास जाएगा। लेकिन आपके पास कुछ डॉक्यूमेंट्स नहीं होगा, आपने क्या 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 अपलोड किया वो मालूम नहीं है आपको, इसलिए आपने क्या करेगा, आपने पूरा फाइल को कॉपी करके आपके पास रखेगा। ऐसा ही एग्जीक्यूटिव का फाइल कुछ आया तो इम्पोर्टेंट फाइल सोचा तो आपने उसको डाउनलोड करके पैरेलल फाइल बना के आपके पास रखे, ऑर्डर्स उसी पे लेना है, ठीक है?
सर, आई हैव अ डाउट। जी, मोहम्मद फैजल, डिप्टी एनएचसीओ फ्रॉम आईसीएस।
नमस्ते सर, बताइए।
Namaste. See, actually, when initially e-office was implemented, there was one small notification icon. Where, if, for example, any receipts which I receive, I mark it down the line and I put a due date.
Yes, sir.
When I put a due date, I, after the due date is crossed, I receive a notification icon saying that you had put a due date. Now, whether any action has been taken or not, something was coming earlier. So now,
okay, sir.
Such thing is not coming.
Sir, for that, what you should do is, sir, when you give this due date, sir, you just notification is not, they have not enabled any notification, sir. The thing is, you just go to your send folder, sir, in receipt section.
Yeah.
There, you will be knowing the importance of that file, sir, like most immediate action initiated VIP references.
Mm-hmm.
From there, this color will be changed, sir. You means like, as and when, sir, we read and send the files to the down level, sir. But all the files will be in the send folder. When you do this out, important or out duty,
no, sir, that I am able to do that. I am doing like that only.
Yes, sir.
I was any
no notifications that they are not given any as such.
I it was available earlier, and I was seeing the e-office of Kerala government. So their user manual has this notification available.
Yes, sir. Sir, in most of the manuals, sir, I have read almost 10-15 manuals, sir, of all this one. There are a lot of things which are available in that are not available in our e-office.
No, whatever is useful for our monitoring, it should be made available, na?
Yeah, it should be available, sir. We can ask our...
As an officer, I mark so many things on the line. I don't remember things. So yes, if I get a notification that you mark this to so-and-so, on this date, they are supposed to give you a feedback, they are not given the feedback. So I can call them and ask.
Yeah, 100%, sir. See, it's like a reminder to you that you have been sent it today and it was not out today, at least 2 hours before. We can ask them and work out in 2 hours and get the reply from them.
So anyway, whatever features are available in other e-offices, we should try to use those things.
Sure, sir. We'll speak with our Chris and get something for that, sir.
Right.
Thank you so much, sir. Glad to meet you. Any doubts, please? If not, we'll call it a day.
Participants? Yeah, hope all are clear.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for giving your chance.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Let me explain this topic on the e-office. Is taking a bit to explain all the doubts by participants. Participants, please join me again Monday. The topic is extra budgetary resources. The faculties in Nageswara, senior instructor, thank you, Anna.
Thank you so much, sir.
Recording stopped.